we look back at the amazing and successful career of Jack Thompson, but there is much more to Jack than his movie roles, as we discover in part two of Craig Bennett's sit-down chat with this movie legend.
There is no doubt Jack Thompson is a lovable knockabout Aussie bloke. At age 76, Jack is one of the most prominent Aussies in cinema history. But over the years, it's been his antics away from the cameras that have ruffled a few feathers.
You are in the history books, of course, as Cleo's first male nude centre.
I am indeed. I am indeed.
How did Jack Thompson get to ditch the duds for Cleo?
I was asked to, of course. Ida came to me and said, would I do it? And I said, why? Well, it's kind of curious request. Would you do it with no clothes on? But it's like saying, would you do a photo with a cat on your head? Now, I suppose, why not? You can find a cat to sit there, that'll do. It just didn't seem to be a great thing to me.
Were you just a little bit terrified, though, of taking it all off and doing your Venus?
No, because, mate, it wasn't a Venus like this, it was a Venus like this. It was like, you know, nice.
That's right.
Rather coyly
there
covered.
There was a hand covering the crowd. There was a,
yes, except that my mates used to say, yeah, have you noticed, mate, he's got six fingers. You know?
I've got to say, Jack, you've lived an extraordinary life. Tumultuous, I guess.
Some of it.
Because you were not born Jack Thompson.
No, I wasn't. I was born John Hadley Payne. My mother died when I was four. My younger brother, bless his heart, now gone, and I ended up at this school at Narrabeen, a fabulous school called Lake House. But since it was 1944, middle of the war really, just toward the end of the war, there were a lot of children from broken homes, because father was at war, mother was at work. I know that from around the age of 18 months, my brother and I were in what I don't suppose they have anymore, a boarding creche. There were a lot of them during the war. At that school, Lake House, is where I met Peter Thompson. He and I, from the age of six, were inseparable. So I would go to his place sometimes on weekends, holidays, a couple of times for a week or something. In the end, Pat Thompson wanted to have another child and couldn't, and had said that she wanted to adopt a child. As it turns out, John said, well, what about Jack? I mean, he doesn't have a family, he doesn't have a home. I've just been with Peter up, he now lives up in Byron Bay, I've just been with him for a few days up there.
And of course, he's the revered film of...
He is, mate, 25 years, Channel 9 on Sunday, the film reviewer. Through John Thompson, I learnt a real love of poetry, and it's remained with me. And Pat was a wonderful mother, just fabulous. And they diligently treated Peter and I the same.
So, Jack, did you ever reunite with your dad?
Yes. He'd had a second family, and his second wife had asked him not to ever tell their children that there were these children from a previous family. So he was kind of embarrassed by it. He also felt that David and I would have recriminations, that he felt guilty about what had happened. And eventually there was a reunion, and the two of us, our physical gestures, our body language was exactly the same. There's something about being of the same blood. 6 months later, under surgery, he died in the operating theatre, and so we just managed to get together.
Never one to shy away from controversy, Jack was soon a tabloid favourite again, but this time with the surprising news he was living with not one, but two women. After the collapse of his first marriage, Jack started a 15-year polyamorous relationship with sisters Leona and Bunky King, causing quite the stir in the 70s and 80s.
Let me say, Craig, there are a lot of men who have affairs. They sneak around behind their wife's back and don't let their family know. For me, I fell in love with two women. and I lived it openly. That's all there was to it, really. It was about love.
Lee and Jack have been together for 40 years now, and with a career lasting throughout the decades, it seems the wild Jack Thompson has finally mellowed, well, a bit.
I've had to, I think. I think life makes you mellow. I think if you survive, if you're still going at 76 and you've come through a wonderful and rich life, you'd better be mellow. You'd better be very happy to be here.
While his face has graced many a screen, his voice has embraced the smooth sounds of poetry, and Jack does it like no one else.
And I somehow fancy that I'd like to change with Clancy. I'd like to take a turn at droving, where the seasons come and go, while he faced the round eternal of the cash book and the journal. But I doubt he'd suit the office. Clancy of the Overflow.
What a fascinating bloke. The two wives things just kind of weeds me out, though. Yeah. Could you deal with two wives?
Why would you want two?
Imagine all the time you spend at Bunnings with two wives.
That's right. I've got to clean out two sheds.
I just thought that was a fantastic interview. Yeah, well done, Craig.
That's the best interview I've ever seen with him.
Yeah. So that's many fabulous. Interesting things that I didn't know.
Yeah. Fascinating bloke.